Hello again! In this video, we will learn how to import data into R or how to do that thing you'll be doing all the time as data scientists. As you can tell, this is an important lesson, so buckle up and let's get to it! If you want to work in parallel with me and still haven't downloaded the resources for the course, please do it now! The resources for this lesson include a couple of datasets which we will be loading into R during the lesson. If you have downloaded them, check where they are saved or copy them into their working directory so they're easy to locate. The file names are pocrdex_comma and pocrdex_delim. Do you remember how to check and set your working directory? The working directory is where we will be loading data from and saving data to. To check what your current working directory is, type getwd into the command. If you're not happy with where this takes you, you can set your working directory by typing setwd and passing a path to the location in your computer that works best for you. Alternatively, you can use our Studio Session tab in the ribbon on top and set your working directory there. Cool! Now that we are in the directory where our files are, we can load data easily. Although there are tons of different data types, we will stick to the most commonly used ones, text and .csv. You can find information about importing other file types in the resources for this lesson. Okay, let's get to it. The general purpose data reading function in R is the read.data function. To load data in the form of a text file from your working directory, pass the name of the file in quotes and then specify at least the following. First, the separator for your data. This tells R what distinguishes your values. Second, whether your dataset has a header row or not. And third, whether R should encode your string variables as factors. Using our Pokemon data, the command looks like this. So, why is it important to specify all of those things? Well, separators tell R how to look at your data and how to structure the data frame. The header signals whether the first row of the data file is values or variable names. If your data doesn't have variable names and begins directly with the first observation, then set that argument to false. Finally, the stringsAsFactors argument tells R whether to convert all string variables to factors or not. Since our string variables include Pokemon names, and these are clearly not factors, we set the argument to false. Of course, there are tons more arguments for the read.table function, but these are the crucial ones to remember. Okay, this covers the basic architecture of reading a data file into R. You can use the read.table function with a lot of different data types because of its flexibility and argument setup. Next, we'll talk about reading specific data types. Comma-separated values, or CSV files, and tab-delimited files. See you there!
For more videos like this one, please subscribe!